Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to tell you guys about the most haunting topic a beginner 3D artist faces, and that is custom posing. I can't make you perfect in posing, but I can make the posing process much easier for you with the help of control rigs. So, as you guys already know, if you open your rival's porting and import any of the characters in Blender, you get some bones with that character. If you select the bones and go to pose mode, you can move individual bones for posing the character. But you can see here that there are a lot of bones and you need Einstein level brain for posing these models. I saw many guys using this complicated bone setup to pose the model and I am really surprised how they even did it. Okay. Luckily, Rivals Porting provides a simpler solution of this problem. A lot of people know about this, but some don't. So basically, you can get a simplified control rig with the help of changing some settings in Rivals Porting. So guys, getting this control rig is really easy. You just need to open your Rivals Porting application and go to the export settings. You can see export options here. Just click here and you can find armature settings. In armature settings, you need to change the first setting, that is rig. Okay, this changes the rig type on your 3D models. Okay, so by default, this is on default rig FK. You need to change it to tasty rig IK. Okay, what this does is it will give you control rigs on your 3D model and make your model much simpler for posing and doing other stuffs. Okay, so now you are good to go. You just need to go to this assets tabs and go to any skins and just press export. Now the skin will have control rig. Okay, so since Emma Frost is the new character, I will tell you how to get this control rig on Emma Frost and how to properly use them and also how to simplify them. Okay, so let's export this skin into Blender. So as you guys can see that we have already imported Emma Frost rig model in our Blender project, but you can see there are still a lot of bones and it is pretty hard to see what's going on here. But the good thing is we can simplify the bones here. So for simplifying the bones, just select any portion of the bones. You can see these are the bones, yellow thing, the circle thing are the bones. And after selecting the bones, go to the pose mode. You can see here, you can see pose mode. Just go to this pose mode. And once you go to the pose mode, go to this data settings. You can see here is a small data settings. Just go to this option and expand this bones collection. You can see by clicking on this group of dot, you can expand the bone collection. You can see all the collection of the different part of the bones are made by the developer. Suppose we want to change the body pose, so we can turn everything except the body one. We will turn the rig, we will turn on the rig, we will turn off the face, twist, dynamic, deform, tail, and additional settings. Okay, once you have turned all these settings, you can see now we are left with only the body controls, and now it is very easy to pose. So suppose if you want to make any pose, just some random poses, and there is no perfect way for posing. The more you practice, the more better you become in posing. Okay, so it's better to use a reference image. For now, I will just roughly showing. And there are some guys who just select the bones and press G button and just randomly move, and this breaks the model. Instead, you should use gizmos to move. And it's not it's ideal for everyone, but I basically use these gizmos. You can see once you select any bones, you get all these three controls. This one is the scale, and we don't need to actually scale anything because it will do nothing. We can only move and rotate anything. So suppose if you want to move this hand up, you can just use this gizmo tool and move this hand up. You can see we can use this hand and move up, or whatever place we want to do, we can move it, and we can use this to actually align pose up and down. You can see, and you can see right now her hands are little bit below, so just select this and use this rotation tool, and you can adjust her hands also. Okay, so by using this circle things, you can adjust her hand. So this is how you pose. And suppose if you want to pose fingers also, sometimes finger cause trouble. So instead of going from global, you can see this is a global, you can turn it to local, and this will allow the fingers to move in perpendicular direction. You can see now I can easily move my fingers or rotate my fingers. Okay, so this is how easy it is to use this control rigs. And right now I'm talking about hand, but if you want to move anything, you can see her legs are also stitched on the ground. So yeah, it is this control rig is very handy thing, and you can see how easy right now it is to pose with these models. Okay, yeah, so this is for shoulder regions, and this is for head region, this bone. So the more you practice, the more you can make the posing better. So I use reference image to pose the models, so you can do that. So as you guys can see that we have already roughly posed our body, but suppose if you want to add some facial expressions on this character, what you can do is turn off this rig thing and turn on the face bones. Okay, you can see it's still pretty messy here and I can't see what's going on here. So what we can do is just go to this option. You can see this is data properties again, and go to this viewport display option. You can see here viewport display. Okay, you can see there is an option which says in front. Okay, just turn this off. So now the bones get reduced and you only get those bones which actually control her facial expressions. Okay, and the useless bones that are behind her skull gets invisible. Okay, so right now we have only this much bones to work with. This huge bone controls the jaw line. You can see this huge bone controls the jaw thing. You can make some sigma sort of renders with using this. And this one is the eyebrow one. You can tweak or twist the eyebrow with these bones. Okay, so you can see we are controlling the eyebrow here. So if you have seen that sigma edit where it does something like that, so I am roughly trying to make that pose. You can see we have added the jawline, and this basically controls the forehead thing. And you can also, suppose if you want to make your character smile, you can see what parts we need to actually change that. First of all, we need to change these bones, and then we need to change these two bones to actually move her lips up to make her smile. You can see now, right now she is smiling. And suppose if you press S button, or we can use this also to scale. Suppose we press S button and scale this, so you can see this is going out and we can make it further up. Yeah, so she is kind of looking like this. And if you press this circle overlay type of thing button, everything, you will get rid of everything. So you can see this is how his face looks like, some sigma sort of thing. So you can see even the adding expression with this control rig sort of thing is really easy. So go and play around. The more you practice, the more better you get in animating these sort of things. You can also control the cheeks from here and do whatever you want. It's up to you to how you play that. Okay, you can just do this also, and it's up to you. The more you play, the more you practice, the more you use reference images to do this, the more better you get it posing and doing this sort of stuff. Okay, so this is how you pose Marvel Rivals 3D model. Once you have done posing, you can just go to this object mode, turn off all the bones, and then press F12 to render and make sure to add some lights in your scene. And if you don't know how to do all these sort of things, I have already made a lighting tutorial in which I have explained render settings and how to render properly in Blender. You can just watch those tutorial and you will be good to go. So friends, that is all for today's video. I wanted to give more information in this video, but the video will get quite big, so I have decided to make a second part of this video. In that video, I will tell how to pose the characters which don't have any facial expression, like Spider-Man, and posing those guys will be much easier. And also there are many pre-made custom poses for those guys, because we will use Mixamo to rig those models. So yeah, posing those guys will be much easier. So I will make that video in part 2. Till then, goodbye guys, see you later. I hope you like my today's tutorial, and make sure to subscribe my channel and like my video, because this tutorial takes a lot of time and a lot of hard work to make, because there are a lot of trial and error, and also English is not my regional language, so it is super hard for me. Okay guys, so see you later. Make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you guys.